Our adventure begins by visiting the charming city of Stavanger. Stavanger is the fourth largest city in Norway, located on the west coast. This city has over 149,000 inhabitants and ranks behind cities such as Oslo, Bergen, and Trondheim. Step back in time as you wander through the cobblestone streets of the old town, where white-painted houses offer glimpses into the city's illustrious past. Our trip to Preikestolen started early in the morning, driving through 14 kilometers long tunnel. This is the world's longest underwater tunnel. According to the Norwegian weather forecast, we should have sunny and warm weather that day. Yeah, right. Welcome to Norway. Never believe Norwegian forecast. Be always prepared to rain and cold. After 45 minutes, we reached a large parking lot. All the amenities are here, such as toilets, clean drinking water from the tap, a restaurant, a cafe, and a souvenir shop. This is Marius, a traditional Norwegian knitting pattern. It can be found on all kinds of souvenirs such as mugs, sweaters, socks, pins, bennies. After 45 minutes exploration of the parking lot, called also a starting point, it was time to start our 4-kilometer hike. After a few hundred meters up, we reached the first stopping place called Plateau. As you have probably already noticed, the climbing path is beautifully made of stones. These paths were built thanks to Sherpas from Nepal. They have been working from spring to autumn since 2013. Before they started, the paths were half their width. Even now, they are working on a new project and building a new path next to the old one. After another few hundred meters up, we reached another stopping place called Urskar. Pay attention to the line on the map that goes up. This is where the hardest route begins. We already have one, here. The beginning part is also quite hard, especially when you start from the lower parking lot where we started. But before we reach the third and hardest hill, there are still beautiful wooden paths and a swamp in front of us. And here is the place where the fun part begins. A lot of stone stairs to climb. Many of them are also high, which may make climbing a bit difficult for people of short stature or children. Here you can see the swamps and the bridge we crossed earlier. And we're not even at the top of the third hill yet. As I mentioned at the beginning, the weather should be beautiful. Clear sky and 18 degrees. Unfortunately, it was different. Cloudy, foggy, and only 14 degrees. The higher we climbed, the wetter the fog became. The next stop on our list is Chudnane, the place where beautiful lake stretches as I can see. A few steps from lakes, there is an emergency shelter. A few hundred meters more, and we will enter finally the Pulpit Rock. After 4 kilometers and 2.5 hours of hiking, we finally could see Preikestolen. This is the photo queue. I imagine that in the summer season it may be 2 or even 3 times longer. While you waiting in the line, your friends or family members setting themselves here to take photo. Fortunately, it started to clear up later that day, and we could see the beauty of the fjord.